Mad Max hit Australian cinema screens in April 1979. Its cast included Mel Gibson, Tim Burns, Steve Bisley, Hugh Keyes Byrne, amongst others. The film was the most successful Australian film ever made, featuring incredible stunts involving cars and motorcycles. It was George Miller's first film and was filmed around Melbourne and country Victoria. Due to the isolated areas, many locations haven't changed much. The car chase sequences were groundbreaking at the time. I decided to seek out the locations for myself. I've always wanted to do it, so I did. Max was the greatest cop of all time. He single-handedly got rid of the Knight Rider, Toe Cutter, and his entire gang in his V8, or Police Interceptor. But now the time has come for me to get into my movie location, Interceptor, and search the roads, the streets of Mad Max. 1979, the original. Got my keys? Yep. Let's do this. Streets of Mad Max, here we come. After a bumpy start, I was well on my way to the first location of Mad Max. In the opening scene of Mad Max, we get a credit sequence, and then we get a shot of a gate which says the Halls of Justice, and behind it is this sinister-looking building, which is the police headquarters. That particular building was an old Harper's starch factory, and then it was closed down, and after Mad Max, it was turned into apartment buildings, and here it is. You can make out a little bit of it. Some of it's remained and they've changed some of it. There's actually a plaque here that explains about how this building was in Mad Max and how it was a starch factory. How good's that? An actual acknowledgement that this building was in a film. You don't see that very often. Okay, the next scene, we've got a policeman by the name of Roop who was sitting on top of an army bunker. And that place is Point Wilson. Here we have an army bunker. This looks like the bunker that was in the film Mad Max. The scene where the police officer is sitting on top of it and he's having a look at some people that are frolicking in the through his scope on his shotgun. I'm pretty sure that's it. There are some more bunkers further down the road, but they're all a bit closer together. I think I better go. Someone's just shown up over there. Okay, this is not a leftover from the film Mad Max, surely not. It's an abandoned car here on Point Wilson Road. Anyone in there? No bodies? Alright, that's not good. Anyway, moving on.
A man calling himself the Knight Rider has killed a police officer and stolen a police vehicle and is on the run, pursued by police. These scenes were shot in various places like Little River and Laverton North.
Cherry Lane, this is the road where we had this huge car smash scene where just over the road there a van comes out of that driveway and the chase carries on down there and the cops end up pretty much stuffed. And it's up to Max to finish the job, who's elsewhere. We're gonna go find that spot where Max was. This is a very important spot for Australian cinema history. This is the place where we are introduced to Max. He's not mad yet. He's just Max. And he's waiting here
while the police chase is going on with the Knight Rider. And you see him sort of walking around his car, he's fiddling with his car and probably having a look at the engine. And then he gets the call, once all the cops are out of it, he gets the call to pursue the Knight Rider. And he takes off here and takes off down the road that way.
We are next introduced to the character of Goose, having his lunch at a truck stop when alerted to the chase.
The truck stop is just through there. You can't really see much and it is private property, so I'm not going to go in there. Okay, that looks like the diner that Goose is in and eventually comes running out of to join the pursuit. I think that's the roof there, and you can see some writing on the top there. I can't quite make it out, but yeah, I can't believe it's still there.
Max lives with his wife Jessie and young son Sprog in a house on the coast of Fairhaven. A house that's still there today. So that's my next stop.
Max's house is just to my right. It's right on the beach of Fairhaven. And this is just a little trail beside the house. Let's see if I can get a shot of the house. If I can't, I can. That's Max's house in the film. It's still here. And it was really hard to get to this spot, but I'm here. There it is. Still standing. An iconic house. An iconic film. I believe they did shoot the movie inside the house too. How am I gonna get out of here?
Max leaves early for work because Goose wants to show Max a V8 car in an underground car park, which happens to still be an actual car park in Melbourne University. This is a ploy by the police chief to keep Max from quitting his job.
Our top pursuit man wants to quit the road, and we have to seduce him with candy.
People don't believe in heroes anymore.
When do we go for a ride?
I've just arrived in Clunes, and the first shot of the motorcycle gang coming into town was here. They drive down here. Cutter and his gang, they all park their motorcycles here in front of this place. The gang then approach a man and ask him about the next train coming into town. The train which will have the body of the Knight Rider in a casket. I think the coffin was somewhere around here. With the body in it.
The Knight Rider. That is his name.
Okay.
Remember him.
I will.
The gang starts causing trouble, doing burnouts as the concerned locals look on. All this was shot in the main street of Clunes. They start to harass a man and throw him through an entrance to a shop that's still here today. A young couple, clearly frightened by what's happening, jump into a red Chevy.
So the young couple flee the town because of all the violence. And in the next scene, they're heading north up Ripley's Road in Little River. And you can see the Yu Yangs in the car window door. So I'm pretty sure that's it. So that's where we're heading next, Little River. Let's go. Possible this is the area where the Chevy was attacked by the gang, and the couple were assaulted and all that. It was definitely on this road. It's very difficult to find the exact spot where the attack took place. This may be it. The scene where Max and Goose are chatting to a couple of people just here in a very strange looking car. then they get the call about the couple that have been attacked by the gang. And I know this is the spot because this chimney is here. You can see it clearly in the film. Yeah, it's sort of a brick chimney, looks very old. It's very interesting, just before the Rothwell Bridge.
One of the gang members, Johnny, is found at the scene of the crime and taken into custody. The interior of the Halls of Justice was shot at a pumping station in Spotswood.
This is the interior of the police headquarters. There's a scene where Bubba's talking to a man just about here about the car, the smashed up car.
What happened to the car?
Perhaps it's a result of an anxiety.
What's he mean no one showed?
They didn't show!
When no witnesses show up for the prosecution of Johnny, lawyers show up demanding Johnny's release. Goose takes exception to this decision and refuses the request and chases Johnny down to beat the crap out of him. To visit this historical building, you can purchase a general admission at ScienceWorks.
We'll see you on the road, Skag! We'll see you on the road like we saw the night we left him!
The Westgate Bridge in the background was not yet open to the public.
The goose is going to be cooked after that outrage. The gang's all about revenge. In the next scene, we have the gang sitting on a beach, which is a pretty obvious beach for me. So that's where we're going. All right, enough with the music. It's not that dramatic. It's just a leisurely drive.
Walking outfit.
Toe Cutter and his gang are sitting here at this beach, mucking around with a mannequin and shooting it. At one point, Toe Cutter grabs Johnny, puts a shotgun to his head and takes him over there to the beach to go into the water, and I think maybe he's testing Johnny, seeing if Johnny's got the guts to do what has to be done when the time comes. So he's a very nervous character in the film.
I tried to visit this location where Goose drives off on his motorcycle, and it's totally unrecognisable today. It's a street that has been redeveloped, replacing brick buildings with skyscrapers. This is all too common in Melbourne. Much of the pedestrian access is limited as the street is full of cranes, cement mixers and roadworks people. The only building still around in this shot is the building here. But you need to go over to South Yarra Station to actually see it. While tearing down a road, Goose stacks his motorcycle, borrows a car and gets burnt alive while Bubba swats a fly. Goose ends up in a hospital in Melbourne, in the suburb of Kew. Still a hospital today.
That thing in there, that's not the Goose. No way.
Max takes Goose's death pretty hard and quits the force and takes his wife Jessie, his son Sprog, on a holiday.
This is the spot where Jessie goes for an ice cream at Avalon Beach. You can see members of the gang up on that roof there, stalking her and following her, trying to intimidate her. And it was this spot here. There was some sort of a shop here, but it's not. They're all just cabins now. While Max and Jessie are on their holiday, Max is fixing his car, and Jessie, in all her wisdom, decides to go to the beach by herself. She's got the dog with her, but with all the murderers running around and the breakdown of this society, Jessie thinks, no, I want to go to the beach. I find it a very strange thing. So Jessie is lying over there, and you see a motorcycle up the top there. So she's being watched. She's definitely not safe. Jessie returns to the house, fully aware that she's being stalked. She returns to Max, and Max then goes off to find out who's there. And this leads to one thing and another, and then we have the death of Jesse and Sprog, Max's son. They're run down by the gang. And at this moment, Max is sitting somewhere around here. He's about to go on his revenge.
I made my way back to Little River for the scenes of the gang starting their day of possible terrorizing of the population and stealing fuel, unaware they're being stalked by Max.
It's hard to tell, but the part where Max notices the person lying on the other side of the road and he gets shot by a tow cutter or Bubba, somewhere around here, very hard to figure out exactly where. But the fence is the same, and the fence is the same on the other side, so we're pretty close.
Quit going, Bubba!
Max shoots Bubba, and the next man on Max's hit list is the tow cutter. The truck comes over the hill, you can see the rocks on the right hand side, and when Max does a U-turn you can see some rocks there on his side of the road over there, and you can see that mountain through Max's passenger side window when he's driving off past the wreckage, which would have been just here. Wow. Max has one more man to catch up with, Johnny, and he will catch up with him, just like we'll catch up with that location.
I now head towards the final act of the film.
Max gives Johnny a choice. He hands him a hacksaw after attaching him to the car with handcuffs and says to him,
"The chain in those handcuffs is high tensile steel. It'll take you 10 minutes to hack through it with this. If you're lucky, you could hack through your ankle in 5 minutes.
But I've used a hacksaw on steel. I would think it would take less than 10 minutes to cut through handcuffs, but I'm not an expert on it. Johnny's left with that choice, and then Max just leaves, and that's the end of your revenge thriller. That is Mad Max. Well, that's it. Those are the locations of Mad Max. Pretty good. Time to go home. And remember, if you're going to be driving out on the roads, drive safe. Cheers.